Hi. This is a special video for the Kev. This man asked me to do a video on a K-Jetronic adjustment, on the mixture adjustment. So now I will try to do my best to explain that. So let's do it, shall we? What I would have to tell you is, if you never ever touched this screw, if you have never readjusted it, then don't do that. Once adjusted, it is never, and I repeat, never ever going to readjust from itself. Look, in order to know about the mixture, I must tell you again that as you take this 3 mils Allen screw and you push it, and now you turn it either clockwise or counterclockwise, you must know that this little wheel here, let me just show you if you can see this one here. I'm going to put a picture of it. As you then turn the Allen key clockwise, it raises, it goes up, and vice versa. As you turn the Allen screw counterclockwise, it lowers. Once it raises, then at one point it's going to touch the plunger inside the fuel distributor, and then further it is going to deflect it just a bit, but good enough for it. Maybe you don't feel it when the car is on, but when the engine is off, what do you think? Look, where is that fuel going to flow? It's going to flow here and here in the throttle. My warmest advice to you about the mixture is to adjust it once you set everything as it should be set. You must replace your injectors. You must replace your fuel filter. Now, as for you that drive not a Mercedes or other cars with Ke-Jetronic, the system is practically the same. What Bosch created, this sensor plate moves like this. It goes like this, upwards. And this rubber boot, which mustn't be torn either, rests like this. And Mercedes, out of who knows which reason, wanted Bosch to make them the system, but for the sensor plate to go downwards. Okay, this is my public and as hard as a rock attitude that on this CO screw, no adjustment can be done concerning the idle, to raise it or to increase it or to decrease it, to lower it. No, that's absolutely not possible. That's something that is done on the ICV itself from that time. It's there, it's adjusted there. Now we're talking about K-Jetronic. If you have to set the mixture to readjust it out of who knows which reason, then, for example, your car won't even start. The first thing you will have to do would be to take off your fuel pump and to bridge the contacts 87 and 30. Contact 30 is the plus coming, the positive coming from the battery, and the 87 is the positive coming from the pump. And the pump here, it has its positive and it has its negative. So what you do, you practically then bridge two positives and you make this pump run non-stop. If you have to set the mixture, there is something that Bosch calls the initial mixture adjustment. The thing you will have to do is to then to unscrew one of these. Now, only one. Imagine that it would be this one. You unscrew it. You do what I told you to do with the fuel pump and with those contacts to make the fuel pump running constantly. And then you put your Allen screw and you start enriching the mixture. So again, you press, the Allen catches the screw, and you start turning it clockwise. The very moment you see the fuel, just a bit. At the very moment you see the fuel coming out of this line, then let's imagine it's this position. The thing you do now, you turn this Allen for half a turn counterclockwise, so this much, for example, as if, for example, the fuel started flowing from this port as the key was here. And under this condition, every car must start, no matter which one of them, and no matter the mixture, how it is set. And now the thing you can do, well, there are many solutions. There is one more difficult, let's call it like that, to then to start the car. Then you get everything back, your fuel pump, everything required. And then you start the car. And you start then at first, let's say, turning this screw counterclockwise. So you're making your mixture leaner. The very moment you hear like this, the very moment you feel that your car starts shaking, then you stop. And then you turn it again clockwise, but not this much, that it would be a bit like this, then you stop. And wait a bit again, sorry, then you stop a bit and you stop, and then a bit more and more and more. You must be very patient and do it in tiny movements, as I was talking about that, this much for example, just to feel that there was a movement. And again, you make it rich till you now feel that this the engine is going to stall, because the mixture is now becoming too rich, and you see black smoke, for example, out of your exhaust. And if this much was too lean, and this much, for example, let me show you again, sorry, this much was too lean, and this much too rich, then let's take the average. 6 o'clock, for example, you put then the screw in, and you make it for this much. For example, like that. The second solution is this thing. You don't have to unscrew it like me. I did it just to clean it and to wash it. And then you set that gap you want to have of 1.9 mils. That can be solution number two. And then you can have, let's say, it, the best mixture. So it's neither lean nor rich. Okay, the cab. If you liked this video, then please like it, leave a comment, and till some other video, happy Mercedesing, or whichever car you're driving. Bye.